Hi, how's it going?
I'm wonderful, how about you?
Good.
Good, all right.
Hey, let's talk about a Rockwood 8301WS. That's right.
Absolutely. Welcome to the great outdoors. This is the Rockwood 8301WS.
So the number one selling fiberglass travel trailer, although they do make some fifth wheels very similar to their travel trailer. This happens to be their signature series.
Yes.
So that is important because this gets actually built in the plant that has the number one best rating out of all the Forest River products for the highest quality score out of all the different Forest River Yep. manufacturer plants out there. We want to show you some stuff on the outside and then show you some stuff on the inside. This has an outside kitchen, bunk beds, multiple slide outs.
Lots of changes were done to this unit from what I understand.
From last year to this year. Yeah, it's pretty awesome. So this is the outside kitchen. This guy is a nice little secondary awning, you could say.
Umbrella.
Yep, two burner stove out here. Now this fridge is just a 110 refrigerator, so it's not a gas, so it's not gonna keep the food cold. So put your cold drinks in here and call it good. You also have a little spot to pull some stuff in there. An on and off light right here, 110 outlet, more storage over here, and then you won't be able to see this on camera, but if you felt behind here, you would see that that's a piece of pine wood. I don't know if you can see that or not. That's pocket screwed together. It's not a piece of particle board that's been stapled together. So all the cabinetry in the entire unit is made like that so that it's gonna last you a lot longer.
Come on around here, it's starting to rain, so we wanna get inside. There are two strategically placed easy gas quick disconnects. One is right here attached to the slide that goes to your burners. The other is right down here, and that one attaches to your barbecue. Makes it real simple, and you're going off the two tanks up front, so you're not carrying additional tanks just for this setup. We also have a nice little table sit next to the barbecue. You put your burgers and your hot dogs up here as you're going to go and grill them. You've got a nice awning, as you can see. It's about a 16-foot awning. It goes out 8 feet. It is adjustable, but more importantly, look at that nice array of lights. It's LED lights, so at nighttime it'll illuminate this real nice, but won't be so bright and bothersome, okay? Now, you also have your potable tank right here, which is centered over the axles once again, which is very nice. It handles the weight easy. Now, Lippert also has a 10-year warranty on their Lippert axles, which is very important, okay? You have 110 outlets, you have cable inlets. Should you purchase a TV to go out on the bracket, you'd have one. The 55-inch inside is not coming out here, folks, okay? That's staying inside. You also have a gas and electric hot water, 6-gallon DSI hot water heater right here. Super nice, has reset buttons, you'll love it. From here, I'm gonna turn you over to Mate and let him go over the rest.
In case you were wondering what this hole right here is for.
I wasn't.
You weren't? Well, I kind of was at one point.
And I should have been.
This is a fully enclosed underbelly, and it won't be easy to see from here. That is a manual override for slide outs. So
he's right.
This guy is a door that has the radius top. It does have the screen that folds across, and you have a three-step entry instead of just a two-step entry, making it a little bit easier to get in and out. And then this guy is on a friction hinge, so instead of having to connect something back here to hold the door in place, it just stays automatically by itself. You also have slam latch doors on here, and then magnetic clip holders. So instead of having the little plastic one that breaks off and then you have to screw in new holes into your fiberglass every few years, this one's gonna last a lot longer. You also have more TV hookups right here on the side, and you do have more lights in here too. So if you wanted to be able to see what you're looking at, And then this is all aluminum frame. So it's got an aluminum frame superstructure, and you'll notice this is all plywood decking. That's important because a lot of the competition, what they'll do is they'll put that fuzzy carpet stuff or something else to hide the fact that they're using OSB chipboard, which of course, as soon as you get that wet, is ruined. So if you can buy something that has plywood decking, you're much, much better off. And this guy also for construction has the fiberglass that's not only the Lamalux 4000, so it gives it that nice sheen to it, but it's also vacuum bonded as opposed to pinch rolled. The way that these guys do their walls, it is 900, well, they used to say 10 times less likely to have delamination problems, but now it's much higher than that because they've gotten better. And this is about 1 in 900 that fail, compared to about an industry standard of about 1 in 23 that fail. That's super important because if a wall fails on something this size, you have to take out all the slide outs, all the awnings, all the windows, all the cabinetry has to come off to grab that wall out, to fully delaminate that, relaminate that back at the factory, and hopefully $10,000 to $15,000 later, you don't have to worry about it falling apart again. Well worth buying a vacuum bonded product as opposed to a pinch rolled product.
Okay, little more news. It's strong. It's a TPO front end cap that literally they tested it and hit it with sledgehammers, from what I understand.
Yeah, you cannot break this stuff, which is important because if you have rocks flying at 70 miles an hour going down the highway and something hits this, or rain and hail hits
bouncing
this,
bouncing off.
Yeah, you're not gonna mess this up.
You also have a Reese Revolution pivot hitch, okay? Once you remove the two bolts that are back under here, this will actually pivot with you should you not have an extended long bed and you've got a short bed. Excellent, excellent hitch. It's a 16K, by the way.
Okay? The way this guy works is if you, a slider hitch is only as good as you remembering to slide right. It back. By making this pivot point 22 inches further away from your cab, you don't have to ever worry about catching a corner, even with your 6.5, even your 5.5 foot beds I've seen make a 90 degree turn, and hopefully you're not in that situation too often, but you can pull that off with this, whereas a normal slider hitch, you cannot even do it with it slid back at that point.
That's an awesome feature. Now up underneath, if I can get in here, I want to show you another storage compartment. Obviously your batteries go in here, but you could put a couple manual generators in here, a couple 2000s if you wanted to. They could house it if you needed it. Also a slam latch door. You over here, you've also got your retract and extend front legs, docking lights, and this is solar prepped. It's ready to go, okay? So you can get those panels if you want, set them out and plug them right in. Around the back of me, you'll find mate.
I'm back here. This guy does have the dump valves fully enclosed inside the underbelly. So you notice I have a grip on the handle here, but you don't see the actual valve itself. That's because it's tucked in, protected from all the elements inside that 12 volt heat padded. And then right around the dump valve, they put special heat pads around those too, so that you can actually open them and close them without having to worry about those being frozen shut or open. This is just the other side of that pass-through storage. And then over here, this is your outside shower. Now this guy just opens up with a 751 key, which anybody who's a camper person out there probably has a 751 key. This is hot and cold water ran to it. Antifreeze inlet, so if you want to winterize your coach very easily, this is a much better way to do it as opposed to having to take apart your water pump. And it makes a lot less mess.
Cabinets inside.
Yeah, and your cabinets will appreciate that. City water connection, and then this is your black tank sewer flush. So what that means is there's sprayers built into the sewer tank, and it flushes it all out for you instead of having to drag a hose down the toilet and put a wand on there and hopefully not making a mess.
Come on down this way. We got a few things to show you. Right here, you're going to find that there's storage, and it's all aluminum framed, as you can see. And this is under the dinette. So they try and utilize every inch they can so that you have more storage than you need. Come on down this way. You have a second dump zone down here, okay? Why? That's a good question. Because this is a bathroom. the bunkhouse has an extra bathroom in it so that the kids or your guests don't have to go up and bother your mom and dad in the middle of the night, okay? What else you got, mate?
Also, starting just this year, they've actually fixed this floor plan. It used to not be nearly as nice. They've actually added this second entry door.
So this is new to this coach.
This is. So if you wanted to not track mud through your entire coach to use the half bath, you can pull that off right here.
So if you're at the lake, you're at a river, you're somewhere, and you're muddy and wet, you can just hop in here, use the bathroom, and hop back out.
Yeah, use the outside shower, spray off, and then
absolutely.
This also has one of those high-powered max air vent fans with the vent fan cover. As you can see up there, that's a max air vent cover. That's nice because if you accidentally leave that fan open and it starts raining, it'll shut itself. Well, yeah, not only that, but it doesn't even have to shut itself.
Oh, that's
because
right.
Because it has that cover over it, even if it's raining, you could leave that open and not get everything soaking wet.
Yep.
You also have the ladder here. Now, this is a one-piece TPO Superflex roof. The reason why that's important is because it's less resistant to abrasion. It's got a 12-year warranty on it, the same as the best in the industry for a warranty. It's a walkable roof, so you don't have to step in between the trusses and you don't have to worry about the soft spots.
That's right.
And it doesn't chalk like a normal rubber roof where it has the black streaks that run down. Yeah. And what was the other thing? Abrasion, more resistant to abrasion, doesn't chalk, and you don't have to put UV protectant on it like a normal rubber roof does.
Couple of last things before we go inside. You get a big hard cover for your spare tire, and you have the assembly pre-wired for a backup camera on this coach. Hey, Yock, why don't you come in out of the rain? Come on. That's how dedicated we are. We even do this in the rain.
So this is the inside of the Rockwood Signature 8301WS. As you can see, this guy has the super slide in it and the good U-shaped dinette, which everybody loves. Now this guy does turn into a bed if you guys decided that you want extra bed space.
Okay.
If you don't like the small throw pillows, you also have the big throw pillows too. And then this guy is a trifold sofa, so makes into a bed. Pretty easy. And I like that you still have walkable room if you do have to use that in the bed position for whatever reason, right?
That's right.
Getting out of here in a hurry.
Makes it simple.
Also, you'll notice, so this guy folds into a bed as well. And then this guy has large pull away doors on both sides. So if you want to be able to access more stuff, you can. These are all, the shades here are all day night shades. So this is your night shade. This is your day shade. And then right here, these are, this big one anyway, is an emergency window. So even though it's raining outside right now, you could leave that open and not have to worry about getting stuff soaking wet, which is nice. Storage-wise, you have a lot more storage in here. So I'll show you over here on this side first. So this guy opens up, and as you can see, there's plenty of pantry space to work with. And if that wasn't enough, you have more pantry space over here. So, and a large drawer if you needed
pots
more
and
drawers.
Pans.
And notice how when I close these drawers, they close on their own that last inch or so. So I'll go ahead and close it, see how it does that. That means as you're driving down the road, common problem in campers is your drawers are all flung open. This will help protect that from happening.
Yep.
Over here in the countertop area, the kitchen, you have raised panel cabinetry, so nice throughout. And by the way, this sticker right here is what all Forest River coaches come with. 24/7 roadside assistance, that's included in the first year, and they have a 1-800 number to call right there. These are Corian countertops, so they're a true name brand Corian hard surface countertop. Pull down sink faucet right over here. We also have a stainless steel sink. It's split half and half. So pretty nice. And then you also have a 22-inch oven as opposed to the 17.5-inch oven. That's pretty standard. And then a knife rack in the back. You have a nice rock type material on the back instead of just paper. And then this guy folds up. These right here are kind of cool. This is instructions on how to do a few things. So if you wanted to learn how to run the stereo, you also have how to run all the app stuff for your control panel as well. So I'll keep that right here for you guys.
All right, over in the entertainment area, I'd like to start just above it though, because you do have more cabinet space up here. They did put the glass inserts. You can put videos, DVDs, all kinds of things in there. All right, things you want out of the kids' reach. Pretty simple. You also get a 55-inch TV. What's nice about this TV, it also, when you do it right, can pull out and you can angle it so that everybody in the room has a very nice picture of the movie that you might be watching at that time. I'm going to get it out of our way, put it back in the lock position. You also have a surround sound system built in. You can tell there are speakers on the ceiling. You also have a DVD, CD, Bluetooth, HDMI ports, and it also has the app to download to your smartphone, which mate seems to have one of those and loves flaunting that in front of me. I don't know why. Also, you have the nice BT, what is that? A 1500 watt fireplace, and it does put out nice heat. It will heat about a 10 by 10 square area. When I lived in my 40 foot fifth wheel, I had two of those, one downstairs, one upstairs, and I never turned the heat on until it was bedtime or it got down to about 32 degrees outside.
So it is true that you can have a app for the stereo system, but the one I'm actually more excited about is the app that you can have for your control panel, because I feel like that's a lot more useful. Let me show you what it is. You can download it for Apple or Samsung or Google Play. It's called IRV Technologies. You just have to click accept and then go to settings, available device, and then you click connect, and then after you're connected, you can do whatever. So you can control things like your slide out, which I think is important, because if you're right next to a tree, you want to be able to put that slide out and be out there by the tree and the slide out, so you know if you're going too far. Also, if it's raining outside, if you want to put your awning out before you walk into your door, you can do that from your car, really. Right. If you wanted to control your hot water heater, you can do that. Your lights, all kinds of utilities for your electric side and your tank heaters, your water pump you can control, your meters, so you can tell how full your battery is. Like right now, my battery is 37%. Fresh water, black water, everything you can control and look at from here, which is awesome.
Can you say techno nerd?
Or if you're not a techno nerd, that's okay too. Come over here, push the power button, and push the button that you want on and off. They make it as super complicated or easy as you want. Moving on. Bathroom. This is the Jack and Jill bathroom, which people tend to like just because you can access the bathroom from the master suite. Hello. And over here, you'll notice this is nice neo-angled shower glass. You also have the skylight above you, so you can get a lot of natural light, as well as some extra headspace if you want. Down here, porcelain commode instead of a plastic one. A second rain-sensored max air vent fan with a cover on it, so that you don't have to worry about rain getting inside here. And the controls are all right there for you. Medicine cabinet here, towel rack, soap holder, toothbrush holder, and then extra storage here, GFI protected outlet, and right over here on the side, you have a linen closet. Now this is super deep because it's on the slide out, which is nice. Hidden hinges, I forgot to point out that earlier. And then this is the same slide out, but it is for your bedroom. So lots of hanging space. And what else do we have in here, Gary?
Well, in here, besides that closet being slid out, and which nice, you pick up an extra 5 feet of it. Something we forgot and neglected was the AC. Now this is a 50 amp service and it has one AC on it, but it can also have a second AC if you want to in the bedroom. What I like is it's all ducted, and even the ducts can be adjusted and point wherever you want to. Not all of them do that in different coaches, but this one does. Now you do have the vent here. You've also got lights. You also have upstairs speakers, okay? So you can listen to music upstairs, downstairs, outside, it doesn't matter. Also get a queen bed. What's nice about this is it does lift up. It does allow you to have storage underneath. And as you can see, they lined it with carpet, so it keeps it nice and clean. And everything you put down there, whether it be pillows, blankets, extra shoes, whatever it might be, or like we used to do, big Tupperware boxes with our clothes that we would wear in the winter were down there if it was summertime out, and vice versa. And it's all framed in aluminum, okay? This coach has LED lights throughout the whole coach. It uses 1/10 the power, 1/10 the heat, okay? This is also a bowed roof. It's got about, what, a 5.5-inch bow to it?
Yeah, okay. Which is nice so that you don't have any standing water on top of the roof.
Down in the corner here, because you've got a little countertop for some radios and whatnot, you also have a charging port. Okay, with a 12-volt and a USB port. You also got regular 110 outlets. Behind me, is, if you can come this way, this is where you could put a TV in the bedroom on a bracket that would pull out and face the bed if you wanted to. And they're all right here. The last thing is, Mate's going to tell you about the new... It's a kingdom style, is it not?
Yeah, Winegard makes a new one that you don't have to crank up and down. Right. You used to have to hang your keys on there to try to remember to lower it down so you didn't take it out.
The sign they made.
Yeah, right? Yeah, a little thing that they... Yeah. Yeah, there was all kinds of weird tricks that you had to worry about. This one, it's like a flying saucer.
That's right.
And it just stays up all the time, and it doesn't add a lot of height to your ceiling or your overall profile, and it's omnidirectional. So you can actually turn this whichever direction is going to give you the best signal.
That's right.
It's digital. Works great.
Octavio, come all the way to the back. There's one thing we saved for the very, very end, and it's one of the most exciting. It's not Mate that's exciting.
Hey.
It's the room.
Some people might disagree with you. No, this is a cool bunkhouse. So you have, they've improved this over time too. This right here is your outside kitchen, but this makes into a bed if you want it to. You have a window up here, and then this guy can actually fold away so that you have just like a little seating area. And then the other thing that they've recently changed is they have nice drawers down here. They used to not have nearly the amount of storage that they have. So three good sized drawers. You have more storage here, which last year's model did not have that. And then another window over here if you want, more LED lights throughout, a spot for a TV backer and a TV if the kids want to hang out and play games and everything. And then back here is your half bath. And then you have that linen closet back here, medicine cabinet back here, more storage back here. So yeah, it's the best bunkhouse model that I've seen in this length by far. Okay, well that concludes the tour of the 8301WS Rockwood Signature.
And I enjoyed doing it. I'm kind of sad it's over.
You look a little sad. I think that's just the natural look.
I need a hug.
Guys.
But it's great. It's filled with everything.
Oh, man. This is a cool floor plan. In fact, I'm excited because they were able to take a floor plan that wasn't working too well last year and add all these little things that really have made it pop.
Spice it up. It pops.
Oh, man. And so a lot of that is because of you guys. Because if you guys pass on the information like, oh, add some more storage in the back or add an outside kitchen or whatever, we pass that information on to the factories and they're welcoming that kind of stuff.
Feedback is so important.
Oh, yeah. So they can improve upon themselves year after year. So thanks for your comments. If you have any questions about this, feel free to comment down below or you can
get a hold of me at Gary@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com.
Absolutely.
Call us.
970-313-4337.
Give us a like.
Thanks, guys.